Hi, and welcome back to another GrandMA3 tutorial on the Event Lighting channel. Today we're going to try something fun. We're going to try to log into the GrandMA3 console on a web browser and see if we can remote control it. It's quite simple and it's quite useful if you have one console at front of house and you have someone who want to help you out backstage. They can simply log into the network and remote control it without having any MA hardware at all. But let's get into it. So here we are on the real console. We need to do a few things. It's quite simple actually, just to set up the correct IP address, start the session and so on and so forth. So you press the menu button, you go into the settings in here, you can go into network, and then you can see the IP address we have on the console right now. And the IP address here is wrong. We need it to be in the 192.168.1 range. So we need to change that. And to be able to change that, you can either press the center of this button here, or you can press and hold this one here, and then it will simply just pop up. And it goes here as well. We can use the button this time. Let's just change it to 192.168.1 dot maybe say 51. So we call the console 51, and then the computer can be whatever, as long as it's 192.168.1, then the number after that doesn't really matter. So we say please, and then we simply accept the changes here. Before that, you know, on the back of a GrandMA3 console, there are three network ports, and it's not a switch, it's three different separate network cards. The first one is usually used for MANET, so when you want to communicate via MANET, it's port number one. And streaming ACN usually also comes out of port number one. Down here, port number two is ARTNET, so if you want to transmit any ARTNET out of your console, you can do it here. Port number three is basically still a simple extra network card. Right now you can take NDI in and show it on your screen, and there's probably going to be a lot of other cool things in the works in the future. But this is basically how it's set up, so we simply apply the change. And you can see now the IP address up here has changed into the one we like. Down here we have a session. It's a Compact XT right now. We can simply just call it maybe session A. And now we're ready to create our session. We can do that over here. And in a minute you can see this turns green. That means that everything is up and running and the session is on the network. It's coming out of the console anyway. Make sure that this one, web remote, is on, because this is what we're going to play with today. So as soon as this one is on, we can go back into the computer again and we can have a look at the settings over there. Just a small interruption here while we are learning about networking. If you want to learn more about GrandMA3, if you are interested in GrandMA3, sign up for my email list. I will send you news and updates on my online school, which is coming up in the near future. If you are in trouble sometimes, if you are learning this from home and you want to ask questions, we have a Discord server you should join as well. There's links in the description for both of these things. Come into Discord and you can ask questions if there's something you can't figure out. There's a lot of people in there to help you. We just crossed the 300 mark in there already, which is amazing. So I hope I see you on Discord and on my email list. And now let's continue with learning about networking and web remotes. Now we set the IP address on the console. We started the session. We need to connect everything to the computer right here. So we need to go through a switch, as you can see on the screen right now. I have a small consumer switch, which is fine for an environment like we have here. But if you are in a live situation, if you are in a venue, I don't want to use a consumer switch. If I were you, I would use something more reliable. But we'll cover that in a later tutorial. But right here you can see we have our switch and we connect both of them. So now we want to get into the computer right here, and we need to go into the network settings here, and we right click and we go into Ethernet, and we just want to go down and make sure that we are in the right range down here. As you can see, I have a DHCP server setting my address automatically, but again, in a venue or something, you want to do all this manually to make sure that you have a complete control over your network. But let's just see if we can go back to connecting the console. We set the IP address and we turned on the session and we enabled web remote over here. We even gave the session a name. Now we can go into the computer and start up a browser and see if we can log into the console. So we go down here and we simply open Firefox and we type in the IP address. And you can see, because I've been in here before, it suggests port 8080 as a network port. And that is what you're gonna use. If you don't use the network port, nothing is gonna happen. But if you type in 8080, which is the port number for the MA session, you can see it jumps in right away. So this is basically how you connect it. Now, if you wanna be in the same user interface as the console, we have to log in as the administrator, because this one doesn't have a user. So when it has a normal user, if you haven't set any users up, it's gonna be the admin user. So what I can do is simply go down to my command line here and I can say login, admin, and that brings me to the exact same window as I had over here. And if I change over here, I don't know if you can see it over here, but the window on the console is actually changing as well. So that's pretty brilliant. And even in our show here, we can now turn up and down the fader over here. I don't know if you can see it. So that's basically how you log into your GrandMA3 console. You can do that on any GrandMA3 console. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got some value out of it. I hope you learned something. And if you want to learn more, just check out this video up here in the corner. And until I see you next time, I hope you have some happy GrandMA3 programming sessions at home, so you can start learning all this stuff. Until I see you next time, have fun. Bye-bye.